Welcome to another episode of Card Corner Club TV, featuring video box break highlights, a better way to do box breaks. Brought to you by CardCornerClub.net, the ultimate online resource for trading card and collectibles information. Today's episode features 2009 Topps Mayo Football. Unlike other retro sets, Mayo is a little more obscure, so a bit of a history lesson might be of help before we start. In 1894, the Richmond, Virginia-based company P.H. Mayo would be the first company to introduce a dedicated football card series in the form of Mayo Cut Plug Tobacco Cards. The Mayo series consisted of college football cards distributed in tins of chewing tobacco. The series contained 35 cards of top Ivy League players from what was then the Big Three of college football schools: Harvard, Yale, and Princeton. As you can see here, the cards featured sepia photos of the player surrounded by a black border in which the player's name, his college, and a Mayo cut plug ad appeared. The cards measured approximately 1 5/8 inch by 2 7/8 inch. Topps isn't the first card manufacturer, however, that has paid homage to this set. In 2002, Don Ross's Gridiron Kings football cards included a 25-card insert set entitled Don Ross 1894, where special football cards were fashioned after the original Mayo series. As far as the 2009 Topps version, its second attempt at the Mayo product, the experience starts appropriately enough with the card's packaging, which resembles a cigar box complete with flip-top lid. 2009 Topps Mayo packs out with 24 packs per box and 8 cards per pack. The current SRP is around $88. Per box highlights include 12 short prints and 23 mini parallels. Collectors will also find one autograph, one relic, and one cabinet-sized card as a box topper. The base set consists of 330 cards comprised of 60 rookies, 100 veterans, 10 legends, 25 public figures, and 55 short prints, seated one per two packs. The entire base set is replicated in a mini parallel version true to the original Mayo size. In addition, there are numerous levels of mini parallels as detailed here. This picture shows details of some of the inserts included in the product. For additional information, including details of all the inserts, you can see the entire sell sheet and the checklist at cardcornerclub.net. What we found: 121 total cards, including 144 of the 330 card base set for a completion rate of 46%. We also found 23 minis, 21 parallels, one autograph, one relic, and one rip card with stated odds of 1 in 192 packs. We also found 0 doubles. The base card design moves away from the traditional black used last year to a white design. Deviating from a card's original design in a retro-themed product can be a bit of a gamble, but I applaud them for at least trying, and I actually think it works fairly well. The color of the player image stands in stark contrast to the white motif, but for me there's just a little too much white on the card. So besides all the base, mini, and insert cards, what did we find? Well, our relic pull was of Stephen Magee, a rookie backup quarterback for the Dallas Cowboys, drafted in the fourth round out of Texas A&M, where he was a two-time Big 12 All-American and a winner of the Bobby Bowden Award. Our autograph card was of Miami Dolphins backup quarterback Pat White, a rookie out of West Virginia. His talent level is unmatched, and hopefully he will eventually earn an opportunity to show what he can do at this level. His collegiate record is unbelievable. Just listen to these factoids. He's got a career record of 34-8 for a starting quarterback, first in West Virginia history, and sixth all-time in NCAA history. He's the only quarterback in the FBS, formerly known as Division I-A, history to win 4 bowl games as a starter. His 4,400 yards rushing are the most among any quarterback in FBS history, and he's accounted for 100 touchdowns, which is a Big East record for any position. Our best pull by far, though, in my opinion, was a rip card. As stated previously, odds were 1 in 192 packs, so a case hit. So the obvious question is, to rip or not rip? Well, it's really no question at all. Rip it! The rip card revealed, as you will see here, a red auto mini of rookie Sean Green. The sell sheet says these cards are hand numbered to 10. Only problem? Well, do you see any serial numbering? So I'm not sure exactly how many of these cards there are. We'll take their word for it, I guess. Drafted by the Jets out of Iowa, he won the 2008 Doak Welker Award as the nation's best running back, becoming the first player in school history to win the honor and the first player to win it despite not being on the team the previous season. After the Hawkeyes won the 2009 Outback Bowl, Green announced he would enter the NFL draft. Green was the only player that year in the NCAA to rush for over 100 yards in every game. The Jets use him as a change of pace back, and this year he has seen playing time in all 8 games, accumulating 217 yards on 44 carries for a 4.9 yard per rush average. Overall thoughts? Despite a seemingly dose of retro-themed sets, Topps proves once again they do it better than anyone. With a knack for detail and appreciation for history, this year's Mayo provides enough components and variation to appease all but the high-end collector. With an attainable base set, multi-tiered parallels and minis, set collectors have numerous choices to pursue. The card design makes it attractive for player collectors, although in all honesty, I really do like the black format from last year better. The requisite bells and whistles of the relic and autograph cards are done well. However, I would like to see this product drop about $15 in retail price or increase the hits per box. Overall, I give this product a B-. A special thanks to Topps. Be sure to listen to Card Corner Radio and download podcasts of the latest collectibles news for free. Connect with us on Twitter, YouTube, and Facebook. And be sure to check out the all-new Card Corner Club Network, a social networking site for collectors, at cardcornerclub.ning.com.